How you guys doing? John here. We're going to do a little science moment right now. Have you ever noticed how certain things act different under a vacuum? We got here our Cromfy. It's a vacuum sealer. Does all the vacuum sealing in bags. But one of the cool things about it as well is it's also got a canister attachment, which we're going to be playing with today. We have our special canister here that we're going to put our lid on. It's going to seal it, and we're going to actually attach right to it. And we're going to vacuum these marshmallows and find out what happens to a marshmallow when it's under vacuum. Hang on, let's find out. Okay, so let's take a look. Before and after. That's pretty awesome, huh? The marshmallow is a sugar stump substance that's whipped. So it's aerated, air is put into it. And as I vacuum that air out, the pressure inside here is way less than the pressure out here, which causes this to now expand. Now the cool, super cool thing is what happens when I release it. So if I pull that off, and then you can now see they've lost a lot. They have lost a lot of their volume. And you see how they're all wrinkled now and all that. If we put them back under vacuum again, it's going to start to collapse them even more when we release the pressure again. But you can watch, they'll expand much easier in the beginning, but there's not nearly as much air to draw out. So the air inside the chamber is going away, but inside the marshmallow, there's not nearly as much air as there was before. They're still going to expand as we draw the vacuum, but they're not going to get as huge as they were before. They were just about filling up the canister before, and now they're pretty much stopping there. Now, they don't seem to be getting much bigger now. It's still a great deal of difference between the original marshmallow and this one here, but let's take a look at what happens now. Now they're smaller than the original one. Isn't that something? They're getting smaller, and you can see they're just crinkled up. All the air inside of them has been sucked out. So now when we release the pressure, and the pressure on the inside is the same as the pressure on the outside, what we wind up with is a smaller, slightly smaller one. All the aeration that makes this puffy and all that is now not in here anymore. This is now firm. All those little cells, the little air pockets inside, kind of like a cell inside, but the air pockets are crushed now. And that marshmallow, that's why it looks all wrinkled, has now sucked in. There's no more aeration to it. So that's kind of cool. What a marshmallow does under vacuum. We used our Cromfy vacuum sealer. It does bags. It does everything. It's a very cool unit. I'll leave a link down below. This is a one of the sealing canisters. Sometimes I use this for putting like pork chops and stuff in there. I'll vacuum the air out and it'll do marinade. So these are kind of cool units. I'll put a link to that Cromfy down below. Have a good one. Alright guys, to do this we used our Cromfy here. It's a vacuum sealer. It's a pretty nice little unit too. Nice unit. It's got your canister stuff, your different modes for, you've got normal, and you've got gentle, moist, dry foods, vacuum seal, regular's just sealing it. If you need to seal it, stop, on and off and all that. It's a pretty nice unit. And to do the actual marshmallows, This is one of those canisters we used with the seal on it. That's all we use, so you know what we use to do the experiment. Nice little unit here. I'll leave a link down below where you can get this, and I think I have a link on where you can get that. I'll check and see, but I got a link for this. So I'll leave a link down below. Cool little experiment. Try it yourselves.